Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning English. This is Colin.
Hello, everybody. This is Nora. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Okay, so Colin, 你最近有没有听到一个网络的热词叫做杀猪盘？
A pig butchering plate?
Well, actually, it's not really killing a pig. 就并不是真正的去杀猪，而是把受害人比作了猪。那这个词呢，其实指的就是那种网络诈骗的骗局。
Online fraud.
Right, and more specifically, it's a romance scam. 说的更具体一点呢，就是婚姻诈骗，利用感情来骗钱。
I see.That's why they named it pig butchering.
Mm-hmm.
Firstly, they have to build the trust, which is similar to, you know, like raising a pig.
Yeah.
And then after gaining the victim's hearts, they will try to trick them for the money.
Yes, exactly. 那我们刚刚用到了两个词都可以指诈骗。第一个呢就是 fraud, 法律上呢我们用这个词是非常的多的。那另外一个就是 scam, 指的就是骗局。Romance scam 就是指的感情诈骗了。
Yeah, internet scams are actually nothing new anymore.、Mm-hmm. Roses are red, violets are blue, the gorgeous date you met online may be scamming you.
Exactly, 说得朗朗上口啊。那这几年呢，我们经常就听到杀猪盘这个词，其实对它的套路也非常熟悉了。但是呢，这类案件还是非常的常见，可能就是骗子也变得更加聪明了吧。
Maybe.The scammers are becoming more sophisticated as well.
是的，那今天呢，我们就一起来就这个话题聊一聊。我们的内容呢，都整理成了文字版的笔记，欢迎大家到微信搜索“早安英文”，私信回复“笔记”两个字来领取我们的文字版笔记。
You know, this kind of romance-related scams are probably the most costly form of online fraud.
Absolutely. 你知道我其实印象中最深刻的类似案件啊。就是几年前有一个软件叫做 WePhone, 那这个软件的创始人苏小茂，他当时就被骗婚勒索了千万，然后最后呢选择了自杀。
I think I might have heard of this. It was quite a sensation at the time.、
Mm-hmm.
He committed suicide by jumping from the top of an apartment building, right?
对，他最后迫于无奈就直接从天台跳楼了。那他的遗言提到他自己的前妻霍欣欣用到了极其歹毒这四个字。
She was very calculating and vicious.、
Mm-hmm.
She had posed as such an ideal wife before the wedding.
Right. 那么描述这位前妻的时候啊，我们刚刚就用到了两个词，一个是 calculating. Calculate 等于就是计算，但是后面加了 ing 呢，就变成了形容词，表精于计算的，心机重的。
Yeah. Calculating people are good at deliberately planning to get what they want.Often by hurting or harming other people.
嗯哼，就是故意的去伤害别人了。那另外一个词 vicious 对应的就是极其恶毒。
Yeah, or you can say cruel or harsh.
非常残忍了。
Now think about this girl. She defrauded $10 million from this man.
是的，而且结婚之前啊，她一直就伪装成一个完美的形象。那么伪装，我们就可以用到这个动词 pose.这个动词啊，其实就是我们拍照的时候会说，哎，摆个 pose。那 pose as someone 就可以表达伪装成某个形象。
Yeah, she pretended to be born to a very wealthy family in Beijing, and she was very considerate to his family members.、
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that's how she built the trust.
Right. 那在建立了信任之后啊，她的形象就完全改变了，而且她也开始采取行动了。我记得最夸张的一点就是他当时吵架的时候居然让苏小茂每天都打$50,000给他作为重新追求的诚意金。
Wow, such a gold digger.
Exactly.
It seemed so obvious that it must have been a scam.
对，我们看其实就感觉这肯定是诈骗嘛，但是当局者迷吧。那么刚刚用到一个词啊， gold digger, 直译就是挖金子的人。那么在英语中呢，我们常见的呢这个单词就是用来去指那些 傍大款，利用感情去骗钱的人。
Yeah, a gold digger is a person, typically a woman, who has a relationship with someone who is rich, so they try to get their money or expensive things from them.
对，但是不过因为他之前塑造的形象就是家境很好，所以这位前妻是坚决不会承认 she's a gold digger. But which in fact, she's of course...
The guy just thought it was normal for her to ask for such an amount of money, considering her family background. Or maybe in the back of that guy's mind, he knew that he was being scammed. But he kept sending money because, you know, he couldn't bear for the relationship to end.
You're absolutely right about this. 那么 scam 这个词我们前面讲过是可以表名词骗局嘛，但刚刚呢就是用作了动词被骗 be scammed. 那其实苏小茂他自己也提过好像有意识到这位前妻并不简单，可能是在骗他，但是最后呢还是相信了。那么这一点呢，我就很同意前面说到的，或许他就是无法忍受恋情的结束了。
Right, and in the end, the girl threatened to expose him for possible tax evasion and demanded $10 million for compensation. That's also the reason he chose to commit suicide.
对，最后索要千万的赔偿金，这个就是根本到最后已经支付不起了，所以选择了自杀。那么前面其实讲到了一个词，就是 tax evasion， 这个呢就是指偷税的行为。当时呢，他的前妻也是用偷税这个理由来威胁他去给千万的这个赔偿金。
Actually, after hearing this story, you might find that this is a pretty typical scenario. The girl is not using many smart strategies.
Scenario 意思就是指的场景情节了。那 a typical scenario 这就是常见套路。我们其实仔细想一想啊，这位前妻好像也没有用什么聪明的技巧，就还是那些非常常见的套路啊。
Yeah, you know, posing as desirable partners on dating sites or through email, winning the hearts of their victims and ending up fleecing them of all their money.
对，反正就是先假装完美的形象，最后赢得芳心，就开始前面说到这个词杀猪了。而且有一个单词我们要注意啊，就是 fleece. Fleece 就是指的剥削。
Whatever they did before, they will always come to this step.
Exactly.So you may wonder, how is it possible people still fall for them if this is so typical and common? 就是为什么同样的套路总是有人上当呢？
Well, it seems that sometimes loneliness overrides one's common sense. And that's also why in those romance scams, the lonely hearts are the biggest targets.
对，的确是的啊。那 common sense 呢，我们知道就是指的常识了。可能真的就是很多时候你的孤独已经胜过了你的理智还有常识，所以你就被骗了。
Yeah, they lost their common sense. When people have been lonely for a long time and suddenly an ideal partner appears in front of them, it's easy to fall into this kind of romance trap.
对，其实就是利用了这些人的感情弱点吧。但是我觉得啊，大家以后就尽量养成一个意识，就只要提到钱，就马上警惕，准备跑路，因为其实我就这样的。
You did the right thing.
Yeah.
After all, if this person was truly the one, they're really not likely to put you in this kind of compromising situation in the first place.
Exactly. Compromising is 就是指的 embarrassing. 那如果是真心对你好的人啊，他们其实不会一开始就找你要钱，让你在这种非常难堪的处境了。
Yeah. And finally, remember that it's okay to say no and to be skeptical.
Alright, 就不要觉得自己不好意思拒绝了，到时候钱没了自己还非常的难过。那好了，我们其实这期苦口婆心了很久，其实就是想告诉大家不要被这种杀猪盘给骗了。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
那么今天的节目呢也到这里结束了。 That's all for today's podcast. This is Nora. Thanks for listening.
This is Colin. See you next time.
Bye.